with Chief Meteorologist Michael Coates.
A very windy start to the high school football season getting started tonight with strong winds gusting up to around 40 miles an hour and temperatures much cooler today. Also, the biggest problem still, the smoke blowing in from all the fires in central Idaho. That is still just blanketing the region in this ugly haze. 81 degrees outside in Idaho Falls. The sustained winds at 26, but gusts again up to 40 miles an hour, and it is bone dry outside. Let me show you the map outside. We're into the lower 80s, like I mentioned, throughout much of the upper valley, upper 70s in Blackfoot, lower 80s in Pocatello, upper 70s in Jackson Hole, and West Yellowstone, we're at 75. Current wind gusts, now these are the last wind gusts of just the past couple of minutes. We're up to 31 in Pocatello and 33 out of the southwest in Idaho Falls. Jackson's at 22 and 17 in Soda Springs. We're going to continue to see this stuff here through a good portion of the overnight hours as this cold front exits off towards Wyoming and Colorado. We're in the dry slot, but in the wake of that cold front for another day until we start working on those thunderstorms coming back up from the south on Sunday. So let me take you to ViperCast. I want to start you off here at 6 a.m. tomorrow morning looking at a beautiful sunny day, a little bit on the smoky side because the winds are going to back off a little bit in the morning. So hopefully we're bringing in a little nicer air quality for early tomorrow, and then the smoke's going to start coming back in by the afternoon hours. Then as I set this into motion, watch those thunderstorms hit into Utah Saturday evening, but not really getting into Idaho until we push the clock till Sunday evening here. Sunday, want to stop it here at 3 o'clock. You can see the thunderstorm starting to run back in, mostly into the mountains there for Idaho mountains into western Wyoming and southwest Montana. Let me show you the forecast for tonight. I want to take into central Idaho first at 43 in Challis and 39 in Arco. Arco, a high of 85 tomorrow, 86 in Salmon, into the southern highlands, the Malad at 50 tonight, 47 in Lavin, 51 in Pocatello. Pocatello at 86 tomorrow, so a little cool from those mid-90s we were hitting just a couple of days ago. Idaho Falls around 44 tonight and 44 in Rigby. IF at 84 tomorrow, 85 in Blackfoot, and 86 at the INL. Going into the Snake Highlands with Island Park just above freezing tonight, and it will be cold enough. West Yellowstone, for the first time this season, going below freezing. 28 degrees for the low, 42 though for Rexburg. Rexburg at 83, and tomorrow only into the mid to upper 70s for the mountain locations for Island Park and West Yellowstone. To the southeast we go, 39 in Montpelier and 37 in Pinedale. Soda at 42. Soda, you're hitting a high of 79 tomorrow, same deal in Montpelier, and 80 for the Star Valley. So let's get to the 8-day forecast. First up, Idaho Falls. You'll see the upper 80s return on Sunday, but we're going to see breezy conditions Sunday and Monday as we have the thunderstorms in the neighborhood and that unsettled atmosphere. Getting into the later half of next week, though, it's going to be into the mid to lower 80s by next weekend. Rexburg at 86 for Sunday and 87 on Monday. Upper 80s will come in Tuesday, and then we're going to bring into the lower 80s by next Saturday. Take a look at Pocatello, 90 degrees, a hot weekend ahead with Sunday bringing in a little bit of a breeze and thunderstorms in the mountains, but I don't see much in the amount of thunderstorm activity coming in for the valley. You're looking fairly dry here for the weekend. Blackfoot upper 80s on Sunday and Monday into the mid 80s late into next week with lots of sunshine. And overnight lows will also start to get a bit cooler. Falls just around the corner. Jackson thunderstorms on Sunday around the Tetons. And then we'll see the 70s return to the forecast for Thursday and Friday late next week. Leading into next weekend, there are some cooler temperatures, but we're starting to get a little closer to September and fall here, and we're going to start feeling it out there.
Yeah, but we haven't felt it so far very much, have we?
No, and the fires are probably going to burn all the way until we start to see the snow. So we're going to be probably dealing with the poor air quality all the way through into September and October.
All right, thank you, Michael. And just ahead, we're taking you to the field as high school football players prepare for the first kickoff of the season. And up next...